Hello everybody and welcome back to another community game. This is going to be a first for our stream. We're going to do a 7-way diplomacy turbo random on Britain. And the three civs they're allowed to choose, we are playing on the British map. As you can see, here's England, Scotland, and Ireland and Wales. A little bit of France on the bottom here. So to go with that theme, these players are only allowed to choose between three civilizations. They are the three civilizations that have been in that area, which will be the Celts, the British, and the Vikings. So they have their choice between those picks. They're going to be making enemies, making allies, whatever it takes. But at the end, there's only going to be one player left, and they are playing on turbo random. So things are going to move pretty quickly here. As you can see, the resources get collected very quickly. We all hate Britain more than you. So fast. Yes, it's very fast. This is going to be great. Anyway, let's introduce our players. We have Wormy Wormy playing as the Celts. We have Leo Nunes playing as the Britons. Dobbs playing as the Vikings. Noboru playing as the Vikings. Noboru is the highest skill player in this lobby. Haru playing as the Vikings. Aquino playing as the Britons. Also pretty good. And Hank playing as the Celts. So we have some very different civilization starting positions. We had three players kind of on the islands. There's some good resources there, as you can see. And then four players on the main island. And these guys are probably going to duke it out really quickly here. In fact, probably be a pretty bad disadvantage for the players in the middle. We have Noboru in the middle and Dobbs in the middle, which both these guys are pretty good. So if anything, should help even out the skills in this game, I think. If that's my justification for this. But we're going to see things moving pretty quickly here. We did start in the feudal age. They have seen the map. It is explored. I do like to tinker with my settings quite a bit. We're going to see Wormy Wormy going with some early fishing ships. And we should see the action pretty quickly here because, again, turbo random. Things not going to take very long before things get started. Now, I have no idea who is allied with who. We're just going to have to go back and forth here. So let's see who's allied with who. We have Leo Nunes. I believe you can check it in... that doesn't work. This one? Nope, can't check it. Wait, did I? Yeah, I can. Okay. Leo Nunes is enemies with everyone, unless the people he's neutral. So he hasn't started out being allies with anyone. He's not going to try to backstab anyone or anything like that. And I know village is going down to boars. Just heard it. It's too fast for a lot of players. Let's check Dobbs. Dobbs has allied with Wormy Wormy, who's on the bottom here. And he has also allied with Leo Nunes, who's on the left here. But Leo Nunes has not reciprocated the ally, I believe. So these two, for all intents and purposes, can be going at it. However, Wormy Wormy is allied with Dobbs. Now, Noboru, let's check Noboru. Has he allied with anyone? Noboru is enemies with everyone except for Wormy Wormy. It looks like Wormy Wormy, his strategy is going to be ally against a lot of guys. Sit back, build his army up, and then maybe change his alliance later on. Let's check Haru. Haru is allied with Wormy Wormy. Wormy Wormy, who is Wormy Wormy not allied with? That's a better question. I do like the strategy. It's my strategy. So, Wormy Wormy is allied with Haru and Hank, and the rest are either neutral or enemy. Haru and Hank. So, Haru and where's Hank? Hank is yellow. So, these are all over the place. Players are allied with each other that aren't allied with each other. It's not reciprocated. This is just crazy. We'll have to watch and see. I mean, there's no other way to do this. No going back and forth. So a few fire ships out from Aquino. He's going to establish early water control. He's getting his fishing starting. Oh, I'm reading off other statuses. Yeah, that's I believe so. Close the stream. Close the stream, Wormy Wormy. You big cheater, you. That's how he won last game. He's just a big cheater. Big cheater head. Anyway, so a few players going for the water. We have all the islands players, not surprisingly, going for the water. We have Dobbs and Nobiru going for the water. A little bit of water for Haru. The only player not going for water is going to be Leo Nunes, who has instead gone for a full wall. Now, we'll have to see which civilization actually has the advantage here. Between the Britons, Celts, and Vikings, the Vikings should have a sizable advantage on the water. However, they do not get fire ships, so that could be a weakness for them. The Britons, I think, might have the strongest army on the land, although you could also argue for the Celts. And the Celts are kind of best of both, I think. Their navy's actually not that great. They probably have the weakest navy out of these three civilizations. They do have a very strong economy, though, and a pretty decent land army, so we'll have to wait and see. Red, we peace.
Yes.
Oh, I hope you guys are peace. No one's attacked at this point. Nobiru is going to go for landing to this gold? To get the relic? I don't know. Not sure what's happening. Wormy's going to be up to the Castle Age. Both these players are up to the Castle Age, except for Dobbs and Leo. Except for Leo Nunes. And Nobiru's just going to mine this gold. There's no jabs for you to vote for. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. The jabs weren't loud here. So Aquino's going to be the first one to get aggressive. We saw him with some fire galleys here. He's actually landing? What? He's landing. What is Nobiru doing here, too? What is this? What is this? Are these two coordinating? Let's go to Aquino. Are they coordinating? No, they're not coordinating. They're definitely enemies with each other. I don't know what's going on at the stage. What is going on? Nobiru is building town centers everywhere. We have some knight and mangonel raiding from Dobbs. This is why Nobiru is going everywhere. He's abandoned his original town center. He's getting hit heavily from Dobbs. And Leo Nunes is just sitting back at the top for the time being. We have a castle drop from Wormy onto Haru. I thought these guys were allied. They are allied, okay. So these guys are buddy buddies. But Nobiru is actually having a really hard time. I thought he would, being in the middle. This town center is getting taken down by the war galleys. We see some archer raiding from Aquino. This is why this map is so interesting. Aquino's literally took in a ship and from a very early game said he wants to take out Hank. He wants to have access to both islands. You have all three islands, you can place a hotel on there and claim monopoly. But Nobiru is getting hit really hard. Hank is the only one with the lower score. And Nobiru's attempt to land this island too. We're gonna have Wormy wall it off. So he's not in a good position. This is the best he's got. He's got this town center. There's plenty of space in this back area if he can somehow make it there. But otherwise, looks like Nobiru will be the first to be eliminated. What is Hank's defense been? I don't see any... What he needs is a siege workshop with those Celts mangonels to help defend against these archers. He can still defend this. But he needs those mangonels. He's going into knights currently. Let's check how many he has. Hank, how many knights you got? You've got a good amount. A good amount of knights. They could definitely clean up these, these archers. Hank saying, it's a party at my place. Everyone is invited. Yeah, just what has happened on his island? Why is this island so popular? Nobiru is who you betted for. Well, you might lose a lot of sheep, my friend. Teal saying need resources. What a good ally he would be. Creating nice and trusting relationships. Now, these guys will have to eventually backstab each other. It is on last man standing. It looks like Wormy is setting his sights onto Dobbs. This can relieve a bit of pressure from Nobiru's now three town centers. And Haru's starting to push out with his castles. Leo Nunes is going to make himself known here, but he's going to get cleaned up by these knights. What's with these archers? They're not really doing too much. Not too much attack. Castle for Leo Nunes. Could get denied, though. Here comes the knights. Oh, this is going to be so close. This is going to be so close. The knights are cleaning up these archers. Oh, looks like the castle will go up, though. And some quick balls from Leonidas. Nice play by him. This will give him some space to work with. That's what you need. You need space in this game. It actually looks like... somehow Noboru is still here. I don't know how he's still here. But it actually looks like Akina's been cleaned up on this island, and Hank should stay in this game. So who's in the best and who's in the worst position? Noboru is still in a bad position, but he's getting his economy rolling. It looks like Haru is going to start to raid him with berserks. How often do you say that? Wormy is in a great position, I must say. He's got water control. He's doing some damage to these other players. He's really putting a hurt onto Dobbs. Gray pay tribute or die. That's funny. That's really funny. Will Noboru pay tribute? He's going into the Imperial Age. I'm going to go to Wormy. See if he actually gets the tribute. I would pay the tribute, man. I would pay the tribute. Nobody's trying to build town centers everywhere he can. This is what a good player does. Now, only three players in the Imperial Age. We have Haru, Akino, and Noboru. Oh, I missed this. Akino's just... Hank never used his cavalier. He never used his cavalier, and now he's got a big problem. Hank is going to have to migrate somewhere. He can't deal with British Arbalest with most of the upgrades. He needs to deck a transport and move somewhere else, and that is exactly what he's done. He's got this little island here. This island could work. You can play some farms there. This is where the gold mine is, though. Look at this. Plenty of open space here. Plenty of free range. So it looks like Noboru didn't pay his tribute. Haru is playing tribute to Wormy. These guys are such great buddies. Can't wait till they turn on each other. We'll hit blue. So Akino's going to be the first target. Akino, what kind of alliances has Akino made? He has made no alliances this game. So Akino's all by himself. Noob says GG. So Dobbs is going to say GG. He's got sandwich. Thanks for playing, Dobbs. Yeah, he got sandwiched between Wormy and Leonidas. They're rocking a hard place. So he will be the first one eliminated. We still have Hank in the game. I don't know how much longer he's going to be in the game, though. All he's got is this town center on the top. The question is, has Hank allied himself with Leonidas? Hank? Hank is allied with Leonidas. Now, I don't know if this is going to be a worthwhile alliance for Leonidas, because obviously Hank is going to have to provide something in return eventually for this relationship to work out. So, Akino, he's cleaned up this island. He'll have plenty more space to seed his farms, plenty more wood to chop, plenty more angles to build his army from, and plenty more gold and stone to mine. So that is all really good for him. There we go. This is what Hank has to offer. He has to offer markets for trade. Now, how is Noboru hanging in there? He's getting currently two castles on this main island. He's playing it like the Vikings should. The Vikings should take every little tiny island and just dock them. That's what they should do. And go in for pirate raids. Because we all know the Vikings were pirates, right? Same thing. Yeah. Noboru is doing his best. He's trying to build on this right side. He's found the gold mine zone, kind of. But so have the Leap Berserk. And they are so well upgraded. It's not even funny. Town center goes down in an instant. Noboru, bad spot. Very bad. This is what happens when you don't ally with people. Wormy's going to go to galleons. The Celts don't have the best galleons. They're missing Bracer. And a few longbowmen for Leonidas. Now, who's Leonidas' threat? Let's see. What are the teams here? It's getting much clearer as this game goes. Now, Wormy's only neutral, so they're basically enemies, and so is Haru. So I think we're going to have a team on the left, if you can call this a team. We're going to have Hank and Leonidas versus Wormy versus Haru. Nobiru's going to be on his own, and Akino's going to be on his own. And Haru just changed his diplomatic stance to enemy with Leomunas. Not surprising at all. So who has the best chance at this game? Look at Nobiru. Look at poor Nobiru. Three castles on the same island. I never thought I would see the player Nobiru, who's a very well-known player, he's known for his streaming. Three castles on a single island. That's funny. All the water control for Akino, though. Britain's pretty good, maybe. And Akino's currently the top scorer. He's the top dog. He'll take access to this top island, have all those resources. He's going to want to expand even more, I believe, though. Nobiru's going to get cleaned up from this right side. There's plenty of resources still here. And these two are going to go at it. We have elite longbowmen. And what we should have is some siege or road raiders from Wormy. So this game is very interesting at this stage. Do you have cannon galleons, please? Do the Celts not get cannon galleons? That surprises me. Do they not get cannon galleons? I just have to check this. Whenever I'm surprised by the tech tree, doesn't happen often. No, you do get cannon galleons. Don't get elite cannon galleons. That's the thing. I think elite has 2 extra range and more attack. Things have stabilized a bit. We're gonna see these two teams go at it. We have a lot of longbowmen for Leonidas. Not a lot of army from Wormy. Wormy is going to focus on the water, but Akino is so strong on water. I think he should be able to repel this. Look at the fleet just moving across the map. Nobiru can't win, but at least he can lose for a long time. I don't know about that. Nobiru is building some elite longboats. Oh, this is funny. This is funny. Hank saying he doesn't have enough gold for imp. Yeah, Hank, you need to build out your economy a little more than this, I think. And Nobiru's town center still here. Man, the town center goes fast to longboats. Goes down fast. So what will stop Leonidas from claiming this entire island? Wormy is only making champions. He needs rams. Rams are the best counter to the Britons. And there we go. There's a bit of trade from Hank as well. The trade cox. Wait, what? Oh, this is what? This is sneaky. So Hank is aligned with Wormy, while Leonidas is fighting Wormy. That is a complicated relationship. So Hank, theoretically here, Hank can backstab Leonidas and still have an ally in Wormy. But Hank is obviously going to need the support of his ally here. He needs the space. Akino's so strong in this matchup. Akino's going to move out with some Britons, with some Arbalest of his own, and take on this army. Would Akino be the one to win this game? Meanwhile, Leonidas is trying to push against Wormy. Wormy's going to catch a break here. So a big difference between the long... Why can't I click on a single unit? Longbowman and Arbalest is going to be one range and one attack. And one Pierce Armor, I believe, too. So that's a pretty significant difference. But at the moment, Leonidas is just going to have the numbers for now. So down goes the army of Akino. Akino's fleet, I was watching, they're gonna take out these berserks. And down goes Hank's town center. It's not looking good for Hank at all. I'm surprised he's actually even still in the game. What is this? Look at this, we have a land galleon. Oh, just HD things. We have a land galleon sinking into the land. That is, aside from Nobiru's three castles here, that's probably the second most entertaining thing I've seen in this game. Man, what is Nobiru doing? Oh man, he's even losing his castles. Aquino friends, Leo Nunes. That would be such a strong alliance. They've actually friended each other, look. They friended each other. That means it's going to be either Haru or Wormy Wormy that has to go down next. Red, get your galleons fast. This is looking very bad for Haru and Wormy Wormy. Who resigned? Nobiru resigned. Oh, poor Nobiru. Didn't have a chance to get back into it. Thank you for playing Nobiru, though. It was very entertaining. Anyways, looking very bad for Haru and Wormy Wormy, I feel. The alliances are all stacked against them. Leo Nunes is going to continue to move in here. He's going to move in with these longbowmen, a very good unit. Aquino can attack from the shorelines. So two of the best players allied against each other. Allied with each other, that's what I meant to say. Now Wormy Wormy is building his fleet. Remember, don't get Bracer. I don't see Aquino's fleet anywhere. Here's his fleet. Gonna move around the back. I think that Wormy Wormy has a bigger fleet at the moment. Wormy's saying he needs the cannon galleons at the coast of castles. Now, of course, they will be cheaper for Haru, and he gets the lead, so that's why he wants them. And Hank is building market here. Trade here. So castle goes down. This pure army, this pure infantry army composition, not going to do too well against longbows. We have to see the siege. And here comes Aquino's fleet. Wormy Wormy, he's landed. He needs some more wood. He's out of wood on his island. So the disadvantage is starting on the island. Although the advantage is, of course, you don't have to deal with anyone early on. Although later on you have to move to the middle. But he's going to collect his wood up. Surprisingly, they get a trebuchet. They're going to take off a few of these units, but still, it's not going to be worthwhile. Not going to be worthwhile for our Vikings player here. So Wormy Wormy, he's giving some good pushback. Elite skirmishes, pretty okay. These are such sucky elite skirmishes though. Look at the upgrades. Again, missing Bracer and the last armor. Armor is so important. They're just gonna melt. Ugh. That disgusts me. This is funny. Sorry, this is just too funny. Teal saying push. We're gonna try to push this back for now. Where did the flee from Aquino go? Not quite sure. Oh, that's not gonna work. Well, that push didn't go very far. Here comes another horde of elite skirmishers from Wormy Wormy. Why not make some siege? Do you not have gold? Do you not have wood? Well, you obviously have wood. Maybe lacking gold. There's gold on the top here. And that's what trading's for. So Akina's gonna make another attempt at this castle. Wait, I thought... okay, Aquino's gonna break off the tie. I thought these guards were allied for a second. They were allied. I just mentioned that. I'm not crazy. They're crazy. So, with the breaking of the alliance, that's gonna be bad for Leo Nunes. He's gonna get pushed back. How many resources? There's plenty of resources still left on this island for Aquino. Oh, poor Leo Nunes. As soon as that diplomatic stance broke, it's all downhill from here. I don't have an answer for this. I don't know, Max Crow? What the hell is Max Crow? Looking very bad for Leo Nunes. I think he's getting eliminated pretty soon. He doesn't have much economy left. This is all the army that he's got left. And he's facing the counters here. Now a few onagers from Haru. Haven't lost faith in Akita. Now what happens next? What happens after Leo Nunes goes down? Assuming it goes down. Will he go down? Well, after he goes down, we're going to be left with Haru and Wormy Wormy, the dynamic duo. And Akino. So between those three, I think Akino would be the next target. The thing is, Akino might be stronger than Wormy Wormy and Haru combined. I don't know. For freedom! You can take our lives, but you can't take our freedom! Wait, Leo Nunes is playing as the British? That doesn't make any sense. He's supposed to be playing as the Celts for that to make sense. By the way, that was the worst William Wallace impression ever. Oh, Teal's asking for tribute now. What does that mean? Does it pay tribute or die, or just play tribute, please? Don't have much, okay. Is Hank lying? I hope he's lying. No, he's not lying. That would have been more interesting if he was lying. No trade! Well, you've had the docks up for a long time. Instead, he's got plenty of demolition This is gonna be great. That was an Arnold impression!
Put that cookie down!
This is gonna be great once these demos come out. I hope they destroy all of Wormy's ships. I don't know why he would do that. I just hope. I just hope that's what happens. Oh man, not looking good for these players. What is Hank doing? Hank's got no space in the back. All his villagers forced to the front. Is he allied with any of these players? Yeah, it looks like he is allied with these players. He's been allied this whole time.
Yes.
Yeah, so these guys are all... I just realized what happened here. So I did predict this. So yellow and green were buddy buddies. They set up trade here. And what does Hank do? Hank allies himself with Wormy Wormy, allies himself with Haru, and now Hank is going to go join their side. That is actually hilarious. Leaving Leo Nunes out to dry. Great. That's great stuff. Hank should ask if Leo Nunes could come too. I don't think so. I don't think he's invited. Can you imagine that casting if Arnold Schwarzenegger was casted for William Wallace? How incredible that would be. Leo Nunes has changed his stance from ally to neutral of Hank. That means he'll kill anything but the villagers, I believe. Oh, this is very disappointing. Come on, I want to see more than that. That's it. I'm a man that doesn't get satisfied by small things, small explosions like that. I have big standards, a big appetite. I need to see more. Alright. Haru, he's gonna move around with his fleet of longboats. Oh, what is going on this game? Leo Nunes, he needs to be eliminated. For things to progress, Leo Nunes needs to be eliminated, and then we can focus on the other players. Oh, yes! 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 That is what I wanted to say. I'm satisfied with that. Let's see one more. Oh, yes! Please! Oh, no! Yes! No! Yes! Oh, that could have been better. That could have been better. Three incredible moments this game. That's great. Leo already betrayed me. Leo Nunes has resigned. There we go. We could progress a bit. He's left his market up. Haru's changed diplomatic stance of Hank to enemy. Why? What threat does Hank serve? If anything, he's a valuable trading partner, but you only need one valuable trading partner in the game. So do I see Haru attacking yellow? I don't really see him attacking yellow. No? Yes? No? What is going on? Yeah, there we go. So Hank needs to get with the times. There we go. He's changed it. So poor Hank, he wanted to come for some sanctuary with Wormy Wormy and Haru. Wormy Wormy has taken him in with open arms, but Haru knows better. Haru knows that Hank is just he's good for nothing. He had his alliance with Leo Nunes, and they cut that off. So what kind of ally would Hank be to Haru? That is the question. Hopefully, if we're lucky, this will start a war between Haru and Wormy Wormy as to whether they should accept Hank into their great empire. Is that Michael Bay enough for me? Oh god, Michael Bay. So, longboat versus galleon. We all knew the Vikings had the strongest navy in this matchup. One of the reasons why you might want to pick them. Forget what I said. All hail the British Navy. Numbers matter, man. It's supposed to be. This is still a pain. Nobu's castles are still here. All the ships might have to go around the bottom side. Akito said, didn't say no either. Is Akito allied with anyone? I don't think he is. Definitely not allied with Haru. What? Akino is actually allied with Wormy Wormy. And the alliances go everywhere in this game. There's no clear-cut alliances at all. So where does Wormy Wormy stand in all of this? Wormy Wormy is throwing spears at Akino. Akino needs to update this. So it's Akino versus both these guys. Obviously, if one of these guys is enemy, then that's how it is. And castle won't get up for Haru. So failed castle attempt. Can Akino go 2 versus 1? That's the question. Now Akino still has access to wood. He's got some wood. He doesn't have a lot. Akino doesn't have that much gold in the bank either. He's secured this top side. I don't think this gold's actually very valuable still left here. And it's under the control of Wormy Wormy. If he wants it. Too much craziness. Too much craziness for one stream. So let's see Akito go 2 versus 1. Hey, come on, we can see a little more progress than this. Maybe some rams out for Akito, that'll get things going. The big battle's on the navy is in the navy in the bottom. If Akino can secure the water, which it looks like he will in this battle, if he can secure the water, he can take out about half of Wormy Wormy's economy. He can take out the trade route too, which is so important. And surround these islands, take out these military production buildings, get in all these nooks and crannies. The navy is really important. And Akino, oh, it's going to be close. This is a close fight. Akino's not that dominant on the navy. He's still building galleons, though. This could put him over. Now, Akino, he's got to be running low on gold here sometime soon. He doesn't start to mine. Castle going up. We'll have to see some cannon galleons to actually take down this castle. Otherwise, this castle will definitely do some damage. And here we go. Trebuchet is moving slowly. Gonna take out a few military productions here, a few military productions there. Slowly retake the map. We can see on the mini-map, Akito's starting to have this little portion right here. And he's gonna be growing and growing and growing. Alright, this is something I didn't think I would see. interesting fight Akino has chosen to take. And finally, here we go. Akino with some capture ends. Hank is actually going to make some military this game, and he's going to throw a bit of it away to Nobu's castles. And here comes Wormy. He's going to come out with some Cavalier. That's a good choice. It's an okay choice. Champions would have been better. Possibly. Probably. But regardless, you're going to clean up some of this army from Akino. Akino has got a good foothold, though. He's got a lot of barracks. He's got four castles, too. So you're not going to clean him up that easily. And Akino's just making more of a progress. Oh! Champion's going to get right under these trebuchets. And they're going to take out at least one. Where is Akino going? These trebuchets are all undefended. There we go. Akino's finally noticed. Not before losing one, though. A little bit of missed micro from Akino. Hank, he's just chilling. What is he going to do with these galleons? Is he going to go fight Akino too? A 3v1? Who knows? If Hank actually wants to win this game, he's going to have to build some farms and take some of this wood. There's not a lot of wood to be taken, though. Akino is spamming like a madman. And he's losing, too. He's losing grand. He's going to lose a single castle here, too. So this could be the end for Akino. Akino's biggest fault could have been not making alliances this game. Alright, let's see what Hank does. Hank is... Okay. Hank is gonna fight Haru. Who knows why, while these pikemen poke holes into these ships. Look how good these pikemen are against ships. And did I speak too soon? Is Akino gonna push this back? Man, this is pure madness. Look at this, Longbowman in the top, Longbowman on the left. Wormy's gonna go back. These Celt skirmishes are so weak. These Celt Cavalier are so weak. Not like this. Man, look at this fight. This is ridiculous. This fight is absolutely ridiculous. Anyway, there's three castles remaining here for Akino. Maybe Akino should just focus on this bottom portion, then focus on the left portion. What? That's funny. This is the fourth most ridiculous thing I've seen in this game. We'll create a top five for this one game. Top five most ridiculous things I've seen in this game. Too much craziness for a single game. But Akino's actually going to win this fight. He's a full 1,500 score ahead from the next guy. Oh, these longbows, they'll be fine. They'll be fine. One of these are Viking skirmish. It's much more powerful. But yeah, a little more siege from Akino. We can clear up this bottom side, hopefully. Nobu's still getting the kills. Excuse me. Still racking up the kills. And now you know why we play these games on turbo. On fast speed. Otherwise these games would take 4 hours. But it's cool, you gotta watch a 4-hour game in a single hour. Nothing is gonna penetrate this Longbowman defense. And we just need to see a little bit of siege. I'm just missing the siege from Akino. And Akino actually has no wood and no gold. Akino's actually legitimately out of gold on all of his islands. Out of wood, sorry, on all of his islands. Well, you can take this wood. That would be worth it. He needs to take wood on these islands. He's going to stutter out if he doesn't take any more resources. And he won't be able to rebuild any of these longbowmen that he loses. So let's see who wins this fight. Looks like it's going to be Aquino once again. Not going to lose too much. But he can't afford to lose anything. Where are the other players taking resources? I mean, we're running out of wood on this map. There's wood on the top. We have Hank taking wood on the top. Oh my god, don't tell me we're going to run out of wood on this map. Where is the rest of the wood? All the wood is on this right side. Oh, we might run out of wood on this map. There's some wood here, there's some wood here. A little bit of wood on the bottom, a little bit of wood on the top. But not a lot of wood. This can get messy. This can get very messy. Oh, man. And just to make... Just get one Onish to kill his longbowman. Depends on the micro, man. This is gonna get messy, especially if Wormy Wormy is gonna lose access to wood. Now, what Aquino needs to do, Aquino can secure the game if he secures these wood lines. He brings his villagers over, he saves up, uses his market correctly. Which I hope he has. Does he have a market? Don't see a market. Let's check the market prices. Players should be buying wood. The wood price is still pretty okay. Yeah, you're not getting through this. We might see a bit of a stalemate, guys. It might happen. Wormy Wormy saying go again with his partner. Oh! Oh! Well, this is number five. This is the number five craziest thing. Come on, get them all. Please get them all. You're gonna get most of them. That was a good trade, though. Hank doing some good work. And Hank's got a good trade line, too. At least if you have a trade line, you can actually buy wood. As expensive as that might be. Players have to be realizing at this point they need to get as much wood as they can. I don't know if Akita's realized it. I don't see him taking wood anywhere. Waiting for something to happen. Oh my gosh. Wormy Wormy. Oh, here he goes. Is this gonna be enough? I think this is gonna be enough. This gotta be enough. This Hustler is so weak though. They're gonna melt. The Hustler are gonna melt. Oh, but more Hustler at the side. And... No, oh, the longbowman's too tanky. Castle's going up too. This is gonna be enough. I think it's gonna be enough. It's gonna be close. It's not gonna be close. That's enough, Hustler. Oh, but here's wave two. Either way, Castle goes up for Wormy Wormy. He'll be able to secure the rest of this wood. And it's just a war of attrition, people. It's just a war of attrition at this point. I think Akita's looking for wood. Akita's not gonna find any on the left side. What he's got is what he's got. Akita's now a 90 population. Feedy's light cap just gonna suicide! Delete, delete! Oh, don't run into the devil! Shit! Oh my god. Oh, that could have been so much worse. By worse, I mean better. Haru, just delete the demo! Well, it wasn't Haru's demo, it was Hank's demo. Hank, delete the demo. Alright, Wormy Wormy looks to be winning the War of Attrition. He's got a bit of resources in the bank. I think Aquino's gonna go down. There's no way, if he doesn't take any wood, there's no way he can win. He's not gonna win with this army. That would be left we'll be left with Wormy Wormy. Hank's not gonna win. Wormy Wormy and Haru. And I think Wormy Wormy can win that. Wormy's pushing forward with even more casts. He's got plenty of Huster to go in with. Okay, he ran right past the Nudius he was trying to kill. Gonna garrison up the castle, gonna take down all the longbowmen. Please? Yes? No. No more left wood left for anyone. Just a little bit of wood. Wormy Wormy's gonna take the last bit of wood for here. Several thousand left to be taken. And he's gonna lose a few villagers, but it's definitely worth it. Look at Hank's army though, he's getting pretty beefy. Despite not having a single villager. He has a few idle. So let's see one more final push from Wormy Wormy. He's massing up his Husser. And let's see him go in. Here he goes. He's gonna go in with a few siege rams too. These siege rams are key for him. It's gonna cost him so much to replace these guys, and take him so long to kill buildings without siege rams. And this is such an inefficient fight for him. Are we gonna see one more castle? No, the village is gonna get involved. Akina's gonna say, well played. Akina didn't, he's gonna say that alliance won, yeah, of course. It's Diplo, you have to make alliances. Hanks are playing Akino. Great play by you. Took out Hank very early on. Had a nice claim onto this island. But sadly, it's not going to be enough. We got a three-way. We have a three-way now. These guys are going to have to turn on each other. And who's going to be the first? Oh, come on. Turn on each other. Turn! I regret not losing faith in you, Akino. I think Akino could have won if he took these woods. If he took these woods, he wouldn't have burnt out, could have added more siege. What is Hank doing? Hank is not playing to win. He's playing for the Twitch highlights. That's what he's doing. Okay, is anyone actually enemied with each other? Okay, we have Hank. Hank is allied with Wormy. He's allied with Haru. Haru is allied with Wormy. He's allied with Hank. Okay. These guys love each other so much. Wormy's allied with Haru is allied with Hank. Who's gonna turn first? Why do you keep deleting? Accident. Okay, someone has to turn. I'm hearing villagers die, but it's not anyone else's. Who's gonna turn first? It's not bugged, it's not allied victory. It's last man standing. All they have to do is change the diplomatic stance. No, Diplo doesn't mean your team wins. Yeah, it depends on... There's two types of Diplo. There's Diplo last man standing, and there's Diplo allied victory. This is not allied victory. Alright, let me just message. Alright, Wormy knows it's last man standing. I just messaged him. Haru. Baru knows also. Wormy saying he's not gonna turn on red. Okay. Haru saying he knows. There has to be a winner. We are conspiring. Oh god. Well guys, we're gonna have an intermission now. If you'd like to go get some coffee, go take a smoke, do whatever you like to do. Come back in 5 minutes, and we will see. We will see who turns on who. While we watch these villagers pummel down what's left of Rukrino. How much wood he's sitting at? 7k. Baru is saying he's totally broke. Wormy has actually shit tons of resources. That's what you need at this stage. What does Haru have? No. Haru is broke. Hank? Okay. Hank actually has good resources. Maybe a chance for Hank. Wormy deleted his art markets. There's only one winner in this matchup. We kind of already know who the winner's gonna be. You just gotta turn. Doesn't want to trade with me. We're gonna let this play out. See you, Kino. Thanks for playing. Thanks for playing. It's very much appreciated. We already know who the winner's gonna be. The winner has to be Wormy, right? It can't be super... Oh, can it be? Can't be Hank. Oh, look at this perfect castle. What perfect... What's in it for me? Oh my god, Wormy, just do it! You will win anyway. Can't get through yellow sh- Wormy saying you can't get through yellow ships. This is true. I don't think you have to win, though. Not a good sign when you realize the track has changed in Age of Empires. Alright, Wormy saying his biggest problem is going to be Hank's ships when he turns. Alright, let's see this. Oh, there we go! Wormy changed his diplomatic stance to enemy with Hank. There we go. Come on! Fight! 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 There we go. Run for your life. Yeah, Wormy's gonna have a hard time breaking this. He's got more galleons here. Oh, this is ugly. Oh boy. Is Hank, can you win this? Can you actually win this? Yeah, Haru has nothing. Haru is just an afterthought. And in fact, we're officially out of wood at this point. I think we're, not officially. There's still this tree here. But we're almost officially out of wood. Wormy, his biggest problem is gold right now. Okay, it's gonna be wood soon. Gonna wanna use that market. Can Wormy finish this game out? This is the big question. Wormy saying I have a treb. Well, you better protect that treb, buddy. There you go. There's a treb.
Ooh, gold, please.
Yeah, these guys are still trading, still gathering some resources. We have a cannon galleon out for the castle. Please be efficient with your stuff, Wormy. Otherwise, it's gonna go to a draw. Looks like Haru and Wormy still allied. It's testing their friendship. And the friendship is gonna succeed. Haru is gonna turn on Hank. And let's face it, Haru had no chance in this game. Hank might have had a chance. But with Haru turning, I think that's gonna be it. Why I think Haru has any sort of influence on this game, I don't know. Oh, here comes the demos. Here comes the demos. Oh, this could be delicious. Oh boy. Oh my god. Oh my god. This one just took it to the face. Sold my soul for 500 wood. I believe bought 500 wood is what you meant to say. Okay, Wormy. Wormy, can you finish this game out? You have 200 gold left. You have literally 200 gold left. There's a relic here and you haven't bothered to take it. Are you kidding me? There's two relics here! Are there any more relics? Any more relics I should be aware of? Oh god. The late game struggles. Wormy's got a sizable. Oh! Did I just hear a monk? Yes, I heard a monk. He's gonna get the relics. Nice. Doesn't Noboru have relics? Does he have relics? He does have relics! Oh my gosh. Noboru, you did something good this game. You got two relics. He's got three relics! Wow, what? Do relics continue to give you gold if they're stuck in your monastery and you're dead? I'll have to check the achievements. Oh, this is mesmerizing. Alright, good thing this is on turbo. That's all I have to say. The announcer has gone quiet. He no longer knows what to say. He is stuck in no man's land. He has no more analysis to give. The game has descended into complete chaos, and now there's nothing left. There is nothing left of any of these civilizations. In the battle for Great Britain, all the competing parties have destroyed each other, and they have completely destroyed Great Britain, only leaving ruins to be discovered. Land or sea. Red trade. Nobody is casting. Yes. I have too little resources for ballistics. And chemistry. Alright, let's see where Wormy's monk expedition has led him. He's now found the Relic Island. And should be picking that up fairly shortly. Let's sort out the winner in a better way. Get the relics, man! That's how you sort out the winner. That's what relics are for. Cannon Galleon Dodgeball. No Cannon Galleon Dodgeball. Hank, you annoyance, Hank. You scum. Not in it to win it. Alright. update on Relic Island. The monk has now gotten into the transport. Back to Water Wars. Where he's going to take a nice engagement. There's only so much fleet left of Hank. Going to get slowly whittled away. And I swear to God, if this game gets ended in a desync, I'm going to pull my hair out. Oh! Oh my God! Split the armies! Split the... God damn it! What? What? Oh! Premature detonation. I know what that's like. Forget I said that. Oh, that hurt. That hurt. Any more demos? Is there demos left? Doesn't look like it. Oh, there's plenty more left. My bad. I was being hopeful. So all three players, after some back and forth, have agreed to a treaty. We will have a three-way draw because there is no more wood to be taken on this map. And because Hank's navy is just too strong, we will have a three-way draw between Hank, Haru, and Wormy Wormy. So let's check the achievements. Most units killed for Akino this game. It's kind of interesting. Do-do. Units lost, 1,070 here. So best KD for Akino. Wormy Wormy looked to be the strongest then, but he lost so many units. Who had the most wood collected? Akino had the most wood collected, which explains why he was the strongest. Some of these other players, not so much. Most gold collected also for Akino. Trade profit, huge trade profit for Hank. That was his whole job. His whole job was the trader. Hank the trader. Now, I did want to check something. Nobru is actually collected. Do the relics actually give you gold? Even if you've been defeated? I don't know. 4,000, does that sound right? That probably sounds realistic when he was alive, so maybe. Anyway, here's your timeline. If you'd like to see more community games, please click the link on the left and please like and subscribe on the right. I will see you in the next video. Units lost for her is 666? Yeah.